herself as Ruby the statue. Absorbed in her grief and telling the painful beads of memory behind her closed, heavy, closed hidden eyes, she seemed herself like a corpse, mourning a corpse. Then, all of a sudden, from a slight movement of her back, like a little stirring in the wind, I guessed that she was going to cry. She wept gently at first, then more violently, her neck and her shoulders shaking. Suddenly, she uncovered her eyes. They were full of tears and quite charming. She looked around her frantically, as if awakening from a nightmare. She saw me gazing at her, looked embarrassed, and hid her face in her hands again. Then she burst into convulsive sobs, and her head slowly bent towards the marble crimson. She rested her forehead on it, and her veil, falling around her, covered the white corners of the beloved sepulchre, like a new morning cloud. I heard her moan, and then she collapsed with her cheek against the tombstone and laid motionless in her arms. I rushed over to her, slapped her hands, and breathed on her eyelids.